welcome back to my channel, Blue Nose Trading. My name is Tori Solis, and today I'm going to be testing Everglade glaze from KyMudworks. I'll be testing this glaze on 7 different clay body test tiles, as well as on a textured white stoneware mug. This is a cone 6 glaze that's listed as lead-free, non-toxic, and dinnerware safe by the manufacturer. Before I open this glaze, I'm going to make sure it's thoroughly mixed. My favorite way to mix up my glazes is with my drill and an egg beater attachment. After mixing, it's a good idea to poke around the bottom of the jar with a stir stick to make sure there isn't any mineral clumped up down there. Sometimes I forget this step, but it's better if I don't. I'm going to be brushing glaze onto my test tiles. I brush my tiles in 1, 2, and 3 coats, with the thickest coat at the top of the tile. I fire my tiles hanging in a high lumina rod to see how the glaze will perform on a vertical surface. In this way, I'm testing for running. With the thickest coat of glaze at the top of the tile, if the glaze is going to run, it has somewhere to go. I like to test glazes on lots of different clay bodies to get a general idea of how glaze is going to behave on different colors or surfaces. Everyone out there is working with different kinds of clay, and maybe one of these tiles can help you guess at what might happen for you. As always, I strongly recommend that you make your own test tiles and fire them in your own kiln. Fire your tiles exactly how you would fire your normal work. There are a lot of different factors that go into how a glaze is going to turn out. The best way to see how a glaze is going to work in your kiln, on your clay, with your application, is to do your own testing. Looking at this textured white stoneware mug, this glaze at 2 coats made a soft sage green that breaks nicely over the textured areas on the mug. The surface is glossy and smooth with no signs of running. On my textured white stoneware tile, this glaze is a smooth, soft sage green with less breaking over textures. The tile is slightly less glossy than the mug sample, which makes me think that this tile was in a cooler part of the kiln and didn't get fired quite as hot. Results on the B mix are similarly a nice soft green with more interest and thicker application or over textures. Results on the Guna Frost aren't as exciting as the results on the stoneware tiles. The green is a bit too matte, but I think firing hotter would potentially solve this issue. On my speckled body, the glaze is glossy and has a lovely speckled blue-green color. The speckles bleed through well at 2 coats and fade back at 3 coats. The color on Laguna Speckled Buff is distinctly more green, almost a pastel olive. It might also benefit from a slightly warmer firing, as the surface is a bit more eggshell on this tile. On my red clay body, the color remains that pastel olive, but the breaking on the texture shows a lot of promise. I think further testing on heavier red textures would make for really beautiful work. This glaze looks lovely on Laguna B3 Black. The surface is smooth and glossy. The breaking has a high contrast dark brown that has a lot of potential. This clay can be fickle about glazes, so it's great to see a great fit. All around, this glaze performs differently on different clay bodies, with greens that range from sage to olive. Fire to a neat cone 6, and then possibly go hotter if you need more gloss. Once you find the firing temperature sweet spot for this glaze on your clay body, I'm sure you can find success with it in your studio. Thank you so much for tuning in this week. I hope you enjoyed learning more about this glaze and can make use of this information in your own studio. If you'd like to help support my channel so I can get more glazes to test for you, you can become a supporter of my channel right here on YouTube. If you'd like to see all of the ceramics I currently have available for sale, visit my website, bluenosetrading.com. If you want to stick around for more art videos, be sure to subscribe to this channel, Blue Nose Trading. Thank you for being here until the end of the video. Remember that you have great ideas that are worth exploring. Drink enough water, and I will see y'all in the next video.